don't have to play me backwards to get the meaning of my verse. You don't have to die and go to hell to feel the devil. Start to fade. I had a dream. I was following a barefoot girl beside a stream that flowed around the world. We spoke of many things, though our mouths never moved, as the most peculiar scenes were disappearing into view. Oh, what a dream. Beyond the realm of what pretty little beings, beneath a yawning sky, speaking of God as though they could define music to the deaf and color to the blind, or God to man. And then the leaves became a thousand tears. I was on my knees in a crazy house of mirrors. Couldn't find my face, but a voice was drawing nearer. Hush, baby, sweet baby, hush, don't you cry. And I thought I woke, and my mother was standing there, and my heart broke as the ribbon. Like a crown come down around a not-so-perfect world. In the corner of the dream was the man with the blue guitar. It had no strings, but the music touched the stars. His long dark curls turned to gold before my eyes. The barefoot girl smiled off to the side, and it was real. Then a thousand birds took flight with a joyful noise, and I heard the angels up on high rejoice. I could see my face and I recognized the voice. Hush, baby, sweet baby, hush, baby, hush. It's just a dream.
Fiddler on the roof. Sounds crazy, no?
Tradition.
Tradition! 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 Tradition!
Traditions, we've kept our balance for many years. Here in Anatevka, we have our traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to work, even how to wear clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered, and we wear these little prayer shawls. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know, but it's a tradition. Because of our traditions, everyone here knows who he is and what God expects him to do.
Whole day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers. And who has the right, as master of the house, to have the final word at home? The Papa!
She's pretty.
the sun, the sun's tradition, the sun.
Is the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play?
I don't remember growing older. When did they?
When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be this tall?
Wasn't it yesterday when they were?
She hits her forehand better into the backhand corner of Sabatini, so that might be the place for her to try to do it because it's her best shot, it's her most natural shot.
Mary Jo might want to do this more because Sabatini has really dominated the net area the last set and a half. Of the 17 winners Sabatini's hit, 15 of them have come from the net.
So you get in there and keep
sure.
her from getting in.
Get in there.
15 all.
Here she comes again. Joe was looking for that that little feather volley of Sabatini's. It's partially because of the way she rips the racket, but she likes to undercut her volleys. Mary Jo read it well.
Been in twice as much and won about twice as much.
Gonna be attacked.
Sure.
40-15.
You know, part of percentage tennis is to do what you do best the majority of the time, and when you get a little nervous or things get tight, why not go with what you do best? You have the best chance of making that shot. At least they have to try to beat you.
Is up 4-3 in the second set. Sabatini won the first set.
She was up 3-love, two breaks.
Carlos Kiermaier likes what he sees. Sabatini's coach, pretty good player in his own right. He was ranked as high as about 40 in the world back in 1981. Had a topspin forehand, kind of an effective chip backhand.
Fernandez.
Part of a rock band in Brazil called the Fleabags. They were big.
Were they?
They had all kinds of hits.
I don't have any of their records.
I stayed in a couple of their hotels.
Boy, that could have been 5-3 off that forehand. Again, Mary Jo is more the thinker out there. Sabatini sort of a brawler more than a boxer. She's got a great heart. Again, another forehand.
It's interesting they're trying to play. Sorry, Mary, go ahead.
I was just going to say that's her 12th forehand, unforced forehand. That's been killing her.
Tim Gullickson. Sabatini has been trying to play Mary Jo's forehand, yet these last few points, Mary Jo's run around her backhand to hit her forehand.
Trying to be aggressive, trying to be bold.
You expect to see Sabatini chip and charge now, try to block the return and come running in.
Sabatini, four all.
It's four all.
So two sets in a row, Mary Jo's jumped out to a two service break lead and has seen it evaporate. We'll see if she can pull this set out now.
shaky.
Again, when she seems to try to top it a little more when she's getting nervous.
That was nicely constructed, Tony. She pulled Sabatini off the net and just did a nice inside-out forehand. Got her out of position and then took advantage. Nice 1-2 punch.
That also makes her passing shots a little more effective when you throw that offensive lob up there once in a while.
15-30.
Sabatini's been smart. She's been chipping and coming in a lot. She's also been trying to spin a lot of first serves in so that Mary Jo can't step around and just hammer her second serve.
But her first serves don't have a lot of pace. That one did. That was the hardest one. That was 84 miles an hour. She's been serving in the 50s and 60s.
But Mary Jo's not mentally looking to hurt her off the first serve. It's the second serve that she steps up and tries to do something with it. Big break point here for Fernandez.
You get the feeling this whole thing is going to be decided by attitude, you know? Who's going to pull the trigger?
Quiet, please.
Well, you know what Sabatini's going to try to do. It's a question of how Mary Jo Fernandez responds. Here'll be a good indication to see if she can really hammer this forehand.
She leads 5-4 in the second set.
Fernandez leads 5-4.
You make it sound like you work with Neanderthals.
That's a step up for some of them. I think that Frank DePonte eats his young.
Lenny, sneak previews Monday. Gregory Harrison has a tough job.
I'm a fireman. I smell like smoke occasionally.
But his toughest job is raising his kids.
There's four of them, right?
Being both father and mother takes practice. Catch a sneak preview of the man who keeps his family from going up in smoke.
Fire's kind of a theme.
The Family Man. Sneak preview Tuesday after Rescue 911.
This is CBS.
Lens Crafters presents a major breakthrough in eyewear technology. Featherweight lenses.
At the end of the day, my glasses seem to weigh a ton.
Try our new Featherweight lenses. They're so comfortable you hardly know you've got them on.
Featherweight lenses. Lighter. Slimmer. And oh so comfortable. Only LensCrafters advanced technology can deliver these revolutionary Featherweight lenses in about an hour through LensCrafters in-store labs. New Featherweights in about an hour.
51 minutes, ma'am.
Oh, they're so comfortable.
New Featherweights.
I hardly know I've got them on.
LensCrafters, 5 locations, including Northgate Mall and Tacoma Mall.
You're watching Cairo TV, Channel 7, your 24-hour news source.
And the Friday night movie, Nighthawk.
We could use both of those.
Yeah. Sabatini won the first set, 7-5. Fernandez serving for the second set.
No question that Sabatini is the quicker of the two around the court, more athletic. doesn't mean that Mary Jo doesn't cover court well, but not as naturally and as easily. Neither of these players have done much of that. That's go in behind the opponent. Right, that was a good example. When Sabatini came in, the cross court looked open, but when they cover that, then the down the line, the other side is open. And I think if we watch for that, if they do it, it'd probably be pretty successful for them.
Women's semifinals in the stadium at the USTA's National Tennis Center. The winner to play Steffi Graf in the final tomorrow.
For Sabatini to get her even at 5-0 in the second set. An easy second serve here. She knows Sabatini's going to try to come in behind it.
Five all. Second set. Just can't put her away.
We had four service breaks in the first set. Five service breaks and six in this set. Half the games have been service breaks.
Highly unusual. Fourth double fault. That one was long by 5 yards.
Talked about consistencies. Sabatini has not lost a set to this point.
15-0.
She sure got close the other night with Leyla Mesky.
Yeah.
The young Soviet held her off. Tiebreaker in one of those sets.
Soviet Union coming up with more players, aren't they?
They sure are.
Cherkasov, Chesnikov, Mesky, Zvereva.
Down of the day at the net.
That can take some skin off too.
She got her hand a little bit. I think she might have gotten that left hand. This is a nice big forehand from Mary Jo. She tried to track it down, Gabriella. Never really got close. Dropped her racket. I think she might have... Yeah, she skinned up with that left hand a bit. Bang.
I think her watch came loose. With some skin.
Yeah. Two break points now. Fernandez leads 6-5 in the second set.
6-5.
Your ideal home computer be like? Easy to use, for sure. Yet it'd have the power to run business software without an overpowering price. It'd be simple to set up, with popular options already included. If somebody zeroed in on a unit that perfect for the family unit, it'd really be something. Something exactly like the PS1. A new kind of computer from IBM. With PS1, IBM brings it all home.
Never agree on a restaurant, right?
Hey, I ordered already. I found us a great wine.
Oh, a decision maker.
Oh, this is wonderful wine. I had this at David's.
I served this at my place. It was a big hit.
Oh, you guys, I was hoping you hadn't tried it yet.
Oh, come on. We finally found something we all agree on, you know? I mean, when was the last time that happened?
Ernest and Julio Gallo invite you to try White Grenache. It will change the way you think about Gallo.
So what do we got?
Well, first off, we've got you.
Yeah.
Incredibly versatile, bringing it all together.
And there's you, Terry, four-time Super Bowl champ.
And we got Leslie, a solid journalist, been on the NFL beat for years.
And Pat, with his unique point of view.
And, of course, we're going to have plenty of other experts.
John Madden, Pat Summerall.
Dropping by, giving us the inside word.
Merlin Olsen, Dan Fouts.
They're going to have to tune in early to catch it all.
Randy Cross.
Hank Stram.
Irv Cross.
So we got a lot.
A whole lot.
I wouldn't miss it.
You won't.
The NFL Today, 12:30 Eastern.
Fernandez leading 6-5 in the second set and serving. Sabatini won the first set.
Good speed coming forward by Fernandez. Let's see what she does with her racket to disguise this. Just bunts it over the net. Sabatini not close.
30 love. Sabatini's been to the net 71 times.
Three set points now.
The match is 2 hours old now.
This is her favorite spot for the forehand.
Final set,
down the line, and smartly
serve.
She
Please
comes
keep your
in
seats.
And
One more game.
Blocks
Thank you.
Off the volley. Did she like it?
Final set coming. Sabatini will start it serving. Steffi Graf already in the finals earlier today with a victory over Sanchez Vicario. So the winner of this will have the task of facing Steffi Graf. Just a reminder to our stationed along the line that we'll be staying with this match until its conclusion. We're supposed to be off at the top of the hour, so we'll stay till it's over.
Darn good overhead from that deep in the court. It was high. We've mentioned so many times it is gusty out there.
Taking a pretty good poke at those serves there, Joe Fernandez.
40-30.
That's what got her the two breaks in both the other sets, to get her ahead.
There have been so many breaks in this match. Six each.
So, Sabatini wins the first game of the final set.
Since the Ice Age, man has enjoyed the pleasures of Perrier. Here at the very source, Gauls gallivanted. Romans rollicked. Troubadours trilled. And Napoleon III gave it his royal seal. Times have changed, but not man's taste for Perrier, Earth's first soft drink.
Tennis pump from Reebok. It helps you get around the battlefield
with a little more confidence.
You may not have thought about getting a Sears diehard battery until you've had a little time alone to think about it. Diehard, more power when you need it most.
This is the feeling of shaving. Nothing feels better after. After aftershave skin conditioner.
I'm Menon.
Try raising three kids and one comedian.
Brian, take off the nose.
No nose. Underwear on the inside. You're killing me.
Special sneak preview of The Family Man, Tuesday.
Final set. The women's semifinal, the National Tennis Center, Sabatini and Fernandez. Sabatini's won the first game of the final set. Sets are one all, obviously. Reminder that tonight at 11:30, we'll have highlights of this match, highlights of the earlier match. Highlights of the men's doubles final. M. Ryan and Mary Carrillo will be with you. And then coming up tomorrow, championship weekend. Women's finals, the two men's semifinals. What a lineup tomorrow.
30-15.
Double fault. Number four for Fernandez.
Got a double fault out of that. You know, she's moving around a lot, waiting on that serve. Sabatini dancing around. I think it can be a little disconcerting. I'm not saying that's why Mary Jo double faulted, but it could be. When she sees it, she's got a second serve. Sabatini, she makes a point of making a lot of movement.
Got her.
Yeah, got her cold.
Advantage Fernandez.
Watch Sabatini try to close after this volley. She goes closer to the net and down the backhand side. Just too good. The offensive lob is there for Fernandez if she can make it. This is an awfully tough day to be really accurate with it because it's so gusty and the wind swirls.
Spring of 1989, Sabatini beat Chris Evert and Steffi Graf in the finals of back-to-back tournaments. Really felt like she was going to challenge for number one. And then she beat Arantxa Sanchez to win the Italian Open. Then she had some real disappointments. She had a real tough three-setter with Steffi Graf in the semis of the Open. Boy, I remember that match. She just ran out of gas at the end. And in 1990, she had a really unfortunate ankle injury at the Australian Open. She had to withdraw. That one had a lot of work on that topspin backhand lob, and Mary Jo knew it was just an unplayable lob. Again, the slice is what gets Mary Jo forward, but Fernandez gets caught because now she rolls over it on the very next backhand.
Sabatini wins and leads 2-1. In the final set.
Sabatini leads 2-1.
About on serve, holding their serves. Fernandez jumped out ahead in both first and second sets.
Oh! 30, love.
Again, to remind our station along the line that we will stay until the conclusion of this match.
Sabatini this year has won only one title, Virginia Slims of Boca. It's where she beat Capriati in Jennifer's pro debut. She wants this so badly.
Oh.
It's Monica Seles, who won the French Open this year, has scooted ahead of her in the rankings. Zina Garrison has had a big year.
40-15.
She wants to get back to where she was these last few years. Turn back the young tide of players.
Yeah. I laugh because she's 20.
That's
yeah,
right.
Turn back the tide of young players.
I tell you, I'm real happy that Capriati didn't win against Steffi Graf on Monday. I don't think it's good for the game to have a 14-year-old champion like that. And I don't think it's good for a 14-year-old to have all that pressure.
Oh.
Sure is nice to have Jennifer Capriati around this game. She's got the happiest eyes on the tour.
There, that missed outside the doubles alley.
Break time, Gabby.
You know, Mary Jo must sense, I mean, what a big opportunity she's had, you know, to get into her second Grand Slam final of the year. Big occasion for her.
Thank you.
close enough to touch. But careful if you try, though she looks as warm as gold, the moon's a harsh mistress, the moon can be so cold. Once the sun did shine, felt so fine. The moon a phantom rode through the mountains and the pines, and then the darkness fell. The moon's a harsh mistress, hard to love her well. Fell out of her eyes, I fell out of her heart. I fell down on my face, I tripped. Close enough to touch, but careful if you try, though she looks as warm as gold, the moon's a harsh mistress, the moon can be so cold. Once the sun did shine, good God, it felt so fine. The moon a phantom rode through the mountains and the pines, and then the darkness fell. The moon's a harsh mistress, it's hard to love her well. Fell out of her eyes, I fell out of her heart. I fell down. I tripped and missed my don't have to play me backwards to get the meaning of my verse. You don't have to die and go to hell to feel the devil.
I had a dream. I was following a barefoot girl beside a stream that flowed around the world. We spoke of many things, though her mouth never moved, as the most peculiar scenes were disappearing into view. Oh, what a dream. Beyond the realm of what pretty little beings, beneath a yawning sky, speaking of God as though they could define music to the deaf and color to the blind, or God to man. And then the leaves became a thousand tears. I was on my knees in a crazy house of mirrors. Couldn't find my face, but a voice was drawing nearer. Hush, baby, sweet baby, hush, don't you cry. And I thought I woke, and my mother was standing there, and my heart broke as the ribbon. A crown come down around a not-so-perfect world. In the corner of the dream was the man with the blue guitar. It had no strings, but the music touched the stars. His long, dark curls turned to gold before my eyes. The barefoot girl smiled off to the side, and it was real. Then a thousand birds took flight with a joyful noise, and I heard the angels up on high rejoice. I could see my face, and I recognized the voice. Hush, baby, sweet baby, hush, baby, hush. It's just a dream.
Fiddler on the roof. Sounds crazy, no?
Tradition. Tradition! 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 Tradition!
Traditions we've kept our balance for many years. Here in Anatevka, we have our traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to work, even how to wear clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered, and we wear these little prayer shawls. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know, but it's a tradition. Because of our traditions, everyone here knows who he is and what God expects him to do.
Whole day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers. And who has the right, as master of the house, to have the final word at home? The Papa! She's pretty.
the sun, the sun's tradition, the sun.
Is this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play?
I don't remember growing older. When did they?
When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be this tall?
Wasn't it yesterday when they were?
Thank you.
She hits her forehand better into the backhand corner of Sabatini, so that might be the place for her to try to do it because it's her best shot, it's her most natural shot.
Well done.
Mary Jo might want to do this more because Sabatini has really dominated the net area the last set and a half. Of the 17 winners Sabatini's hit, 15 of them have come from the net.
So you get in there and keep
sure.
her from getting in.
Get in there.
15 all.
Here she comes again. Mary Jo was looking for that that little feather volley of Sabatini's. Partially because of the way she grips the racket, but she likes to undercut her volleys. Mary Jo read it well.
Been in twice as much and won about twice as much.
Got it. She knows she's going to be attacked.
Sure. 40-15. You know, part of percentage tennis is to do what you do best the majority of the time. And when you get a little nervous or things get tight, why not go with what you do best? You have the best chance of making that shot. At least they have to try to beat you.
Is up 4-3 in the second set. Sabatini won the first set.
She was up 3-love, two breaks.
Carlos Kiermaier likes what he sees. Sabatini's coach, pretty good player in his own right. He was ranked as high as about 40 in the world back in 1981. Had a topspin forehand, kind of an effective chip backhand.
Fernandez.
Part of a rock band in Brazil called the Fleabags. They were big.
Were they?
They had all kinds of hits.
I don't have any of their records.
I stayed in a couple of their hotels.
Boy, that could have been 5-3 off that forehand. Again, Mary Jo is more the thinker out there. Sabatini's sort of a brawler more than a boxer. She's got a great heart.
Long.
That's out again, another forehand.
It's interesting, they're trying to play. Sorry, Mary, go ahead.
I was just going to say that's her 12th forehand, unforced forehand. That's been killing her.
Tim Gullickson. Sabatini has been trying to play Mary Jo's forehand, yet these last few points, Mary Jo's run around her backhand to hit her forehand.
Trying to be aggressive, trying to be bold.
You expect to see Sabatini chip and charge now, try to block the return and come running in.
Sabatini, four all.
It's four all.
So two sets in a row, Mary Jo's jumped out to a two service break lead and has seen it evaporate. We'll see if she can pull this set out now.
shaky.
Again, when she seems to try to top it a little more when she's getting nervous.
That was nicely constructed, Tony. She pulled Sabatini off the net and just did a nice inside-out forehand. Got her out of position and then took advantage. Nice 1-2 punch.
That also makes her passing shuttle more effective when you throw that offensive lob up there once in a while.
15-30.
Sabatini's been smart. She's been chipping and coming in a lot. She's also been trying to spin a lot of first serves in so that Mary Jo can't step around and just hammer her second serve.
Her first serves don't have a lot of pace. That one did. That was the hardest one. That was 84 miles an hour. She's been serving in the 50s and 60s.
But Mary Jo's not mentally looking to hurt her off the first serve. It's the second serve that she steps up and tries to do something with it. Break point here for Fernandez.
You get the feeling this whole thing is going to be decided by attitude, you know? Who's going to pull the trigger?
Quiet, please.
Well, you know what Sabatini's going to try to do. It's a question of how Mary Jo Fernandez responds. Here'll be a good indication to see if she can really hammer this forehand.
She leads 5-4 in the second set.
Fernandez leads 5-4.
You make it sound like you work with Neanderthals.
That's a step up for some of them. I think that Frank DePonte is young.
Lenny, sneak previews Monday. Gregory Harrison has a tough job.
I'm a fireman. I smell like smoke occasionally.
But his toughest job is raising his kids.
There's four of them, right?
Bean, both father and mother, takes practice. Catch a sneak preview of the man who keeps his family from going up in smoke.
Fire's kind of a theme.
The Family Man. Sneak preview Tuesday after Rescue 911.
This is CBS.
Lens Crafters presents a major breakthrough in eyewear technology. Featherweight lenses.
At the end of the day, my glasses seem to weigh a ton.
Try our new Featherweight lenses. They're so comfortable you hardly know you've got them on.
Featherweight lenses. Lighter, slimmer, and oh so comfortable. Only LensCrafters advanced technology can deliver these revolutionary Featherweight lenses in about an hour through LensCrafters in-store labs. New Featherweights in about an hour.
51 minutes, ma'am.
Oh, they're so comfortable.
New Featherweights.
I hardly not got them on.
LensCrafters, 5 locations, including Northgate Mall and Tacoma Mall.
You're watching Cairo TV, Channel 7, your 24-hour news source.
And the Friday night movie, Nighthawk.
We could use both of those.
Yeah. Sabatini won the first set, 7-5. Fernandez serving for the second set.
No question that Sabatini is the quicker of the two around the court, more athletic. It doesn't mean that Mary Jo doesn't cover court well, but not as naturally and as easily. Neither of these players have done much of today. That's go in behind the opponent. Right, that was a good example. When Sabatini came in, the cross court looked open, but when they cover that, then the down the line, the other side is open. And I think if we watch for that, if they do it, it'd probably be pretty successful for them.
Women's semifinals in the stadium at the USTA's National Tennis Center. The winner to play Steffi Graf in the final tomorrow.
Sabatini could get her even at 5-all in the second set. Second serve here. She knows Sabatini's going to try to come in behind it.
Five all. Second set. Just can't put her away.
We had four service breaks in the first set. Five service breaks and six in this set. Half the games have been service breaks.
Highly unusual. Fourth double fault. That one was long by 5 yards.
Talked about consistencies. Sabatini has not lost a set to this point.
15-0. She sure got close the other night with Leyla Mesky.
Yeah.
The young Soviet held her off. Tiebreaker in one of those sets.
Soviet Union coming up with more players, aren't they?
They sure are.
Cherkasov, Chesnikov, Mesky, Zvereva.
Down of the day at the net.
That can take some skin off too.
She got her hand a little bit. I think she might have gotten that left hand. This is a nice big forehand from Mary Jo. She tried to track it down, Gabriella. Never really got close. Dropped her racket. I think she might have, yeah, she skinned up with that left hand a bit. Bang.
I think her watch came loose. With some skin.
Yeah. Two break points now. Fernandez leads 6-5 in the second set.
6-5.
What would your ideal home computer be like? Easy to use, for sure. Yet it'd have the power to run business software without an overpowering price. It'd be simple to set up, with popular options already included. If somebody zeroed in on a unit that perfect for the family unit, it'd really be something. Something exactly like the PS1. A new kind of computer from IBM. With PS1, IBM brings it all home.
Never agree on a restaurant, right?
Hey, I ordered already. I found us a great wine.
Oh, a decision maker.
Yeah. Oh, this is wonderful wine. I had this at David's.
I served this at my place. It was a big hit.
You guys, I was hoping you hadn't tried it yet.
Oh, come on. We finally found something we all agree on, you know? I mean, when was the last time that happened?
Ernest and Julio Gallo invite you to try White Grenache. It will change the way you think about Gallo.
So what do we got?
Well, first off, we've got you.
Yeah.
Incredibly versatile, bringing it all together.
And there's you, Terry, four-time Super Bowl champ.
Yeah, we got Leslie, a solid journalist, been on the NFL beat for years.
And Pat, with his unique point of view.
And, of course, we're going to have plenty of other experts.
John Madden, Pat Summerall.
Dropping by, giving us the inside word.
Merlin Olsen, Dan Fouts.
They're going to have to tune in early to catch it all.
Randy Cross.
Hank Stram.
Irv Cross.
So we got a lot.
A whole lot.
I wouldn't miss it.
You won't.
The NFL Today, 12:30 Eastern.
Fernandez leading 6-5 in the second set and serving. Sabatini won the first set.
Good speed coming forward by Fernandez. Let's see what she does with her racket to disguise this. Just bunts it over the net. Sabatini not close.
30 love. Sabatini's been to the net 71 times.
Three set points now.
Match is 2 hours old now.
This is her favorite spot for the forehand.
Final set,
down the line, and smartly she comes in and blocks off the volley. Did she like it?
Final set coming. Sabatini will start it serving. Draw. Steffi Graf already in the finals earlier today with a victory over Sanchez Vicario. So the winner of this will have the task of facing Steffi Graf. Just a reminder to our stations along the line that we'll be staying with this match until its conclusion. We're supposed to be off at the top of the hour, but we'll stay till it's over. Darn good overhead from that deep in the court. It was high. We've mentioned so many times it is gusty out there.
Taking a pretty good poke at those serves there, Joe Fernandez.
40-30.
That's what got her the two breaks in both the other sets, to get her ahead.
There have been so many breaks in this match. Six each.
So, Sabatini wins the first game of the final set.
Since the Ice Age, man has enjoyed the pleasures of Perrier. Here at the very source, Gauls gallivanted. Romans rollicked. Troubadours trilled. And Napoleon III gave it his royal seal. Times have changed, but not man's taste for Perrier, Earth's first soft drink.
Tennis pump from Reebok. It helps you get around the battlefield
with a little more confidence.
You may not have thought about getting a Sears diehard battery until you've had a little time alone to think about it. Diehard, more power when you need it most.
This is the feeling of shaving. Nothing feels better after. After aftershave skin conditioner. I'm in.
Try raising three kids and one comedian.
Brian, take off the nose.
No nose. Underwear on the inside. You're killing me.
Special sneak preview of The Family Man, Tuesday.
Final set. The women's semifinal. The National Tennis Center, Sabatini and Fernandez. Sabatini's won the first game of the final set. Sets are one all, obviously. Reminder that tonight at 11:30, we'll have highlights of this match, highlights of the earlier match. Highlights of the men's doubles final. Em Ryan and Larry Carrillo will be with you. And then coming up tomorrow, championship weekend. Women's finals, the two men's semifinals. What a lineup tomorrow.
30-15.
Double fault. Number four for Fernandez.
Got a double fault out of that. You know, she's moving around a lot, waiting on that serve. Sabatini dancing around. I think it can be a little disconcerting. I'm not saying that's why Mary Jo double faulted, but it could be. When she sees it, she's got a second serve. Sabatini, she makes a point of making a lot of movement.
Got her.
Yeah, got her cold.
Advantage Fernandez.
Watch Sabatini try to close after this volley. She goes closer to the net and down the backhand side. Just too good.
Thank you.
offensive lob is there for Fernandez if she can make it. This is an awfully tough day to be really accurate with it because it's so gusty and the wind swirls.
Spring of 1989, Sabatini beat Chris Evert and Steffi Graf in the finals of back-to-back tournaments. Really felt like she was going to challenge for number one. And then she beat Arantxa Sanchez to win the Italian Open. Then she had some real disappointments. She had a real tough three-setter with Steffi Graf in the semis of the Open. Boy, I remember that match. She just ran out of gas at the end. And in 1990, she had a really unfortunate ankle injury at the Australian Open. She had to withdraw. That one had a lot of work on that topspin backhand lob, and Mary Jo knew it was just an unplayable lob. Again, the slice is what gets Mary Jo forward, but Fernandez gets caught because now she rolls over it on the very next backhand.
Sabatini wins and leads 2-1. In the final set.
Sabatini leads 2-1.
About on serve, holding their serves. Fernandez jumped out ahead in both first and second sets.
30 love.
Again, to remind our station along the line that we will stay until the conclusion of this match.
Sabatini this year has won only one title, Virginia Slims of Boca. It's where she beat Capriati in Jennifer's pro debut. She wants it so badly. It's Monica Seles, who won the French Open this year, has scooted ahead of her in the rankings. Zina Garrison has had a big year.
40-15.
She wants to get back to where she was these last few years. Turn back the young tide of players.
Yeah. I laugh because she's 20.
That's
yeah,
right.
Turn back the tide of young players.
I tell you, I'm real happy that Capriati didn't win against Steffi Graf on Monday. I don't think it's good for the game to have a 14-year-old champion like that. And I don't think it's good for a 14-year-old to have all that pressure. Sure is nice to have Jennifer Capriati around this game. She's got the happiest eyes on the tour.
Bad miss there. That missed outside the doubles alley.
Break time, Gabby.
You know, Mary Jo must sense, I mean, what a big opportunity she's had, you know, to get into her second Grand Slam final of the year. Big occasion for her.